Aquarius, welcome back. Welcome home. It feels really good to have you here now present with me, shuffling cards and seeing what your guides, what spirit messages are available for you now. So of course, this is for Aquarius, Sun, Moon, or Rising, and also my cross watchers, because I'm realizing that there's plenty of you guys here too. What does spirit want you? What does spirit want you to receive right now? What messages do they want you to receive right now? So first things first, you guys, I just heard the word crimson and clover over and over. If you've never heard that song before, maybe check it out. Something about pleasure. Life being a little too abrasive, a little too fast-paced, a little too harsh. And it's time for you to slow down and savor. Savor the senses with the strength card here. Yep. Strength card. Something about the Five of Cups. I know that for a lot of tarot readers, this is a negative card. But I've studied the tarot and astrology almost all of my life, and this is not negative all the time. It doesn't need to be unless you feel that it is. It's not. This is the card of emotions. Of course, it can represent things being incomplete. But what I'm feeling and what I'm sensing for you is that you are recognizing that it's like half full, half empty. And you are recognizing that, you know what, there's a gift here that's meant to be fulfilled, fulfilled. You've felt it before and you're going to want to do it again. And crimson and clover, it's about good luck and it's about blood, life force, energy, and you fulfilling things that really make you passionate, that make you strong, that make you feel vibrant, that bring vitality to your life. Aquarius, there seems to be a lot of movement and speed and action around you for the last few months. We have Knight and Page of Swords, and we also have Eight of Wands. Things have been very fast-paced. If not in your life, then in your mind. We also have the Ace of Swords here. It's information that you're sharing, information that you're receiving, things that you're doing. You're very active. You're very active and engaged and, you know, bouncing around a lot. There's a lot that's required of you. And now Spirit is saying, we want you to tap into the positive aspect of the Five of Cups, which is allowing yourself to not take stock in what you've felt so far, but what fulfilling your cup a little further, so that it is very clear and apparent and abundant to you. This is very much focusing on your pleasure, your joy, your senses. Justice card. It's definitely time. I'm honestly, it feels like life has been very much all work and all play makes John a dull boy. I don't know if you've ever heard that. So you need to have balance here, head and heart balance. What this is where the Five of Cups, I just keep getting drawn back to the Five of Cups, and I don't see this as energy depletion. I see this as energy filling. Filling, really, really filling your cup up and not, I feel like the change, the shift that happens, that's going to happen within you when you start to slow down a little bit. And Aquarius, some of you guys, that's the very last of what you want to do. You feel like there's so much that needs to be done. There's so much that needs to be, so many things that you need to do, so with work, with your goals, with your intentions, with your manifestations. And Spirit is like, you'll get there, but we also want, we can add levels to this that would add value to your experience here on Earth while you're here on Earth. Look at this. Three of Cups and Ten of Cups. I mean, I rest my case. This is about, I'm literally talking about, you know, the levels that Spirit wants to add, and they're like, yeah, we want to add the more joyful things. We want to add the emotional fulfillment. This is not always going to be fast and speedy and pushing forward. It's also going to be slow and joyful and present and sensual. This means, you know, those slow walks in the park. Some of you guys, you're like, yeah, well, I've been out in nature. It's like, yeah, but you've been power walking or jogging through it. So take time to kind of slow it down and to stop and truly smell the roses a little bit. Okay. Interestingly enough, something about the Bird of Paradise candle is coming through for you, and the Nectar of Life candle is coming through for you, because they're very much connected to finding and securing the sweetness. If not, I feel like this Five of Cups card can actually turn into something that feels a little bit more poisonous, when it could be something that's more progressive. Six of Cups. So this is literally about rekindling your passion for life, your joy, your pleasure, the senses for your life, okay? All right, what else do we have here? Spirit, talk to me. Wow, Aquarius, this message is just as fast as you are. Quick, quick, quick. This is like going on a date with your partner, even though you guys have been married forever, in a relationship for 6 years, and just having fun. Ooh, generosity just slipped right out. This is what I'm talking about with the Five of Cups card. I just feel like if there's this very generous pouring into you that needs to happen. Because like you're giving to yourself, but you're giving to yourself in a way that feels, yeah, knowledge, air. This is literally, I think you've been on this pursuit. I'm on the pursuit of happiness, and I know everything that shine and always gonna be good. I'll be fine once I get it. I'll be good. And it's just like, you know, that's true. But along the pursuit of happiness, if you stop and smell the roses, you could be happy right here now presently. You know what I mean? Do you know what I mean? And that's what the Six of Cups is. It's about slowing down and really taking time to kind of savor the innocence of this moment, and not just, once I get there, then I'm going to know. Once I get there, then it's going to happen. Well, ooh. Okay, so patience, Foggy Bay. This is you taking your time to just kind of slowly savor. Then we also have Storm Spirit. So clearly there's some chaotic energy. I feel like it's a lot in the mind. Retreat. I couldn't make this up even if I tried. I'm about to give myself a reading after this because my intuition is on point. I mean, it always is, but Standing Stones, Passage. Again, it's like you want to go. You want to get to the next. It's like this destination addiction. Like, come on back right here, right now, and enjoy, slowly savor the present. My loves, Nectar of Life and the Bird of Paradise candle is going to be your best friend. If you need me, if you're looking for me, you can find me within my apothecary, working my magic always. That's what we witches do. That is bahatilife.com. That's the only place. I know that there's a lot of scammers out there doing the very most. Strength twice. I love that for you. And with the Strength card, yeah, it can be about physical, emotional strength, but I also see it about, I just see it in the sense of pleasure. I see it in the sense of how strong you can be, how strong you are when you say, I don't need to show up for everything because I'm going to show up for myself and slow everything down and not rush forward with my life, but slow things down in order to tame my internal, or to quench, to fulfill, to provide, to nourish, to nurture what I love. And with the Strength card, what you want isn't going anywhere. What you're working towards isn't going anywhere. It's going to be here. So can you just stop with the box of tissues? She's just like, this is mine. She's so cute. All right, my loves, I said what I said and I stand by it. I'm sending you guys all of my love. If you need me, again, you can find me working in the apothecary. The links for that will be down below. Again, fixed candles, intention oils, conjure oils, ritual soaks, herbal soaks for cleansing out your home. There is a strong need to focus on the home and purifying the home, opening up the windows. It is fall time where I'm at. And those fall breezes are coming through, and they are very cathartic and cleansing before we enter into the winter realms, where things start to get slow and still, and we need to like really nourish, nurture, and support ourselves, and we're a little bit more focused on survival. So before we get into that, go ahead and nurture and nourish the here, the present, and the now, okay? All right, my loves, I will see you in my next video. Make sure that you are subscribed so that you don't miss it. Bye.
You were created to live a life of magic, abundance, love, and blessing. all of which will be up to you to call into your life with perfect divine timing. The Hottie Life Apothecary is the magical home of Jessica Alexandria, where you will find a wide variety of mystical items to help you to manifest your heart's truest desires, as well as tools to help you tap into your unlimited spiritual potential. Browse the online apothecary and find hand-fixed candles to magnetize your intentions towards you. You'll find thyme and star-soaked conjure oils charged to anoint your petitions, your body, and personal magical items. You'll also find the highest quality of herbs for creating your own potions and concoctions, and even reserve time and space with Jessica Alexandria herself, who will work with you to create something special and truly yours. Each item found within the apothecary are created with intention in alignment with the movement of the stars to make them even more powerful totems to bring into your own sacred space. Visit BahatiLife.com to browse the apothecary, and don't forget to follow Jessica on Instagram at BahatiLife, where she posts daily messages to uplift, inspire, empower, and to remind you of your magical potential along your magical journey. Blessings to each and every one of you. I'll see you there.